Welcome back to my channel, Lady Team. My name is Nathalie and today we are going to continue working with the art challenge that I've set for myself. And today we're not going to work in the art book that I showed you in two videos ago, but this time we are going to make a painting, but also going to use the oil pastels that I've used before. I'm going to show you what we're going to be making. Okay, so I've already done the setup because I bought this giant board and I am not good with numbers or distances, so I was like, measurements, I mean. So I was like, yeah, I ordered this, it's probably going to be fine, it's way too huge and I still have to cut it down, but this is the big ass thing that we're going to be working on, just for that white paper over there. And what we're going to be making is this from the art book that I've done before, but now we're going to make it big, and the black I actually want to do with paint. I'm not too crazy about paint, I'm not really good with it, so I want to get used to that as well. But the sunflowers and the ribbon I want to do with my oil pastels, so that is what we're going to be doing. So hello, we are going to continue, and you can see that things changed. Don't worry, I didn't get rid of the old sketch, but recently I tried something out with Ecolina, and I'm not sure how it is pronounced in English, but yes, miso, thank you for your contribution. But I tried something out of that, with making first a sketch, and then, because I didn't want the outline to be there, I just wanted to do it with the ink. I used my light pad to paint over it and not have the lines. So I was changing the face because I wasn't really happy with the nose and with the mouth. Then I realized, like, maybe what I can do is do the same thing, but then with the paint, so that you don't have the hard lines, because I sketched a lot and I couldn't really erase them, and I could have used paint, but I was like, maybe use that and a bit more freely, like I want to try that out. So we have here, we have another one that I'm currently have the second layer of primer on. I'm not sure if you're supposed to do that with paper, but I want to try it out. It's on canvases, it helps with, I think, with blending and for the paint to really stick to the canvas. So that's what we're going to try out. I will show you what I've also done. This is the sketch that I done before. Now I can see it a bit clearer. So as you can see, we changed the nose and I changed the lips and everything. Kind of made this a little bit better, and these are better now, the strings. And for the first time in my life, instead of just going with, oh, I think I know what color I want, I actually made some things to see which one I prefer. The purple was just kind of there as another option, which I thought that the colors of the sunflowers would just fall flat a bit, so not going with that. The blue I didn't really like as well either. Doesn't matter, you know what I mean. We also have two greens, and I thought that this one was a bit too harsh, and that is what I usually do when I'm coloring in a coloring book or something. I go in with harsh and dark colors, and they don't match well, but because I go in with them because I like the colors of their own. So that's why I'm proud of myself for this time, first making some swatches and kind of seeing like what would I prefer. So going with a little bit of a brighter green. I have some paints that I'm going to show you now. We're going to be using a cheap paint. Most of the paints that I have are cheap. I have one expensive brand, but I'm too scared to do anything with it now. It's a bit intimidating when it's expensive and you can't really paint just yet. Miso has a lot of contribution today. We're going to be using this. I don't know if it really picks up on camera. It's not really grey. It's more of a vintage green one. Yes, it is Miso. Thank you. It's more of a vintage grey. So we're going to use that as the base, because that one is light enough for the light pad that I can at least get one coat on it. And then the light pad will hopefully, if I did everything correctly with testing, also tested that, if I add enough water, that it still shows the sketch through the light so that I can go in with the black after that. Then we have some more grays, some more greens to really add some depth hopefully and make an interesting background, not one that is just a solid color. And I also, but I'm not sure if I'm going to use them. I have from the same brand a pinkish one and a grayish one, also vintage kind. I thought about maybe including them, but I'm not sure, but we're just going to have fun and try out. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it's going to be fun. Hey Miso! She's just chilling here. Miso! Miso! Ta-da! So as you see, now it's the mint kind of green. What I love, let me get you a bit closer. As you can maybe see, it's a bit mintier than it is in real life. Here on video it's a bit more... It disappears, but in real life it doesn't. And as you can see, it is not perfectly one color. And that is something new for me. What I would usually do is think of the background after I had done the piece, I'll be honest. But usually I just make it one solid color, and as I said, in really big popping colors. And this time I was like, I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do this time is not make it one solid color, but just kind of let the brush do its thing. And it doesn't have to be solid, it just has to be there. And I think it, I like it a lot better now. It was way more free and I actually enjoyed doing it. When I fill it in with one color, I'm just very stressed, especially when the final thing is already on there, or the focus point, at least for what I feel like is the focus point. So this is, I like it way better. Maybe next time we're going to do a painting with just colors and not make a person or something, but just kind of go with that. Because also I can show you, because what I was talking to you about the Ecolina, I also have some paint swatches on here because I was trying out if I can still see beneath it. But I first made a frog, the drawing of what I wanted, and then I was like, well, I don't want the lines, as I explained, so I put this one on top. First we did the Ecolina blobs with the toothbrush, very fun to do. I'll make a video about it that someday. But then the frog is here without the little lines. So that was the idea that I got. But every time you use that little thing with the toothbrush,
you have to make sure that the ink gets off. So I had some tissue paper for that. And instead of just throwing the tissue paper aside for the ink that was still left on it, I started dabbing it on a piece of paper. And it turned out like this. And you may say, well, it's a bit messy. But this, believe it or not, is one I've had the most fun making this. And the most fun making something artsy. In a long time. This was so much fun to make, to just, without a plan, just bob it on there, just dip, stipple. It was so much fun. So even with doing this, I enjoyed it. So I think I want to do something a bit more with that. Okay, I tried to record what I was doing before, but my phone was full and suddenly it just didn't work. So this is where we are right now, taking a little step back. I'm using the ring light, so hopefully the green color of the background is showing up a little bit better. But I'm so proud of how it already looks, and it's not even close to being done. But I'm proud of how the sunflowers turned out. I just really, really like how they look a bit more realistic now on the hat. And the colors are going well. I absolutely love it. And I used Posma markers for the black outlines and for the black dots here on the sunflowers. And to give some detail here on the ribbon. I absolutely love it. It's going so well. I'm so proud of myself for hanging in there. And can you actually see the green color? I hope you can, but we are going to work with that anyway, give it a bit more depth and a bit more color. This is where we are right now. Before I continue, look at how cool it looks. It looks so awesome. I'm so proud of it. For the main thing is I am having so much fun, and I didn't expect that, because usually before, when I was only doing one or two drawings a year, I was like, okay, I'm going to make something and it has to be perfect. It has to come out like I have it in my head. But I'm just going to do the one sketch. I'm not going to try out any colors. I have to do it perfectly at once. And if I don't, for example, like the nose, then I'm just not good at it and I should quit. This time, it took a couple of weeks to get the sketch right. And I'm proud of myself for hanging in there and actually keep erasing it. That's the word I'm looking for, and keep trying to get the nose the way I wanted it to. So I'm having so much more fun and I'm actually enjoying myself. I've been working on this the entire morning and I didn't realize that it was already the afternoon until I got hungry. Until my stomach let me know, like, hey, it's 12, maybe you should eat some lunch. So lunch is almost going to be delivered here, getting a beautiful sandwich, and what we're going to do? We are going to continue painting for a little bit, just filling in everything with black. Well, not everything, just the contour. So this is the first coat. It looks so good, if I do say so myself. I'm just so proud. I'm going to let that dry, and when my lunch arrives, I'm going to eat that, and then hopefully it's dry enough. We can actually dry it with the air dryer now. And then we're going to give it a second coat, because this paint covers really well. This is the expensive one that I'm using, the one from Amsterdam. I can show you. Amsterdam acrylic paint I'm using, the black one. It covers really well, but I still want to give it a second cover.
best it's going to be currently.
So this is the finished painting. I enjoyed it. I had a lovely time. What I really like is that I added a pink. You can't really see it, but it adds to the detail here in real life. What I could have done differently. First a compliment, and then something that I prefer to do differently next time. Then another compliment. Hamburger method. I did do the first layer of the background, and that worked fine. But because I first did a silhouette of the face, you can kind of see that here around it, it's more white because I didn't want to get too close, especially here around the top of the head. It's still visible. But looking at it from a little further away, I'm not too bothered with it. The only line that really stands out to me is that one on the top. We can fix that later, maybe. But yeah, what I'm really proud of is that it looks so good. I'm really proud of myself. Is it the best thing I've made? No, of course not. But I'm proud because I'm already making progress. And that deserves to be said as well. Like, you can always tell yourself, like, I could have done this better. Maybe should have done this. But I'm proud of myself. Yes. I'm really proud of the sunflowers. I really like how the silhouette turned out. And I'm proud of myself for mixing different mediums together and daring to go on with paint. Paint, I don't usually really like using it because I feel like I'm not good enough anyway, so why waste time and effort to do everything? And I don't usually get the blending. Yeah, this time it worked out well. I tried out a tip that one of my friends gave me of just using a wetter brush. Use a little bit more water. And I never thought of that myself, so I'm proud of myself for asking for help and using the tips that I got. So yeah, I'm really happy with how this turned out. Thank you for being here for this video. Let me know what you thought of the process and of the finished painting in the comments down below. I hope to see you in another video, and I hope that you have an amazing day. Goodbye!